Thank you. All right. Is that good? All right, now I face you. Good. I am a super cynical dude, if you could tell already. But I'm so cynical to the point where I just sort of, like, I just want Trump to win for hilarity's sake.
Yeah.
I think it'd be hilarious if he won, because I think, you know, everyone that voted for him, like, all the dumb people will just, like, perish under his regime, and then all the smart people will, like, work around it for the next 4 years, and then we can get him out of office and raise a new Trumpless nation.
Sure.
Hopefully everything will go a lot better then. But, like, if he gets in office and, like, worst comes to worst, like, what? I'll just start selling drugs. What else are you gonna do? He's not gonna legalize that shit.
Yes.
It's gonna be a buyer's market. So, that's my plan, if Trump wins. People are gonna be like, hey, Sean, what happened, man? You're a good kid. You had a lot going for you. Why'd you turn to this lifestyle? And I'll just be like, hey, is that Trump? Trump's in office. Times is rough. I start moving bricks. Got bricks to move. All right, I got time to be talking around. I got 2 phones. I gotta get out of here. Yeah, that's a joke about me selling drugs. I'm 8 years old. I don't like slut shaming. I think it's dumb because I think everybody should be able to do what they want with their body. I don't really care. But here's why I think it'll never go away, slut shaming. If we were talking and we were gossiping about somebody, if you told me, like, hey, that girl over there, she sleeps with a lot of dudes, I'd be like, great, good for her, more power to her, love her. But then if you then said, oh, by the way, also, that woman is your mother, I'd be like, we're fighting now. How fucking dare you insinuate my mother's ever had relations? I was born to be a stork. I was dropped right off into a crib with taffeta along the sides. It was beautiful. That's how I entered this world. We're fist fighting. Fuck you. Because, you know, everyone likes sluts. No one wants. You wouldn't walk in on your mother, even if it was your dad doing your mom. You wouldn't walk in and be like, yeah, mom, get off. What are you doing? Fucking gross. Oh, poor mothers. Getting cock blocked by their children. I really like, I was pretty much raised by the internet. That's not good, kind of, but it's whatever, I'm fine. I turned out okay. But it's weird now because, like, you have to use your real name for everything. Like, you started with Facebook, so you can't, like, I can't be analbag69 on Facebook. I have to use my real name, so you can't talk shit anymore because people are like, oh, that's this guy. I'm gonna see him tomorrow and tell him what a dick he is. But you can still be a complete asshole as much as you want on video games on the internet, and I still do. By principle, every time I buy a new video game to play online, I check to see if I can crouch. Because I want to teabag everybody that I defeat. I want to get the maximum amount of disrespect as possible when I defeat a foe. You can't do that on Facebook. Can't tell people if they like how your nuts taste on Twitter. It's not good. Maybe, man. All right, I'm gonna do one more, and I'll get out of here. Star Wars just came out for this next joke. Let's pretend. Right? Yay! And when that movie came out, there was I was reading this article with some people that were very upset that they're like, hey, there's no Asian people in Star Wars. What's up with that? Why do the Asians get to miss out on a Star War? That's not cool. But then I thought about it, and I was like, you know what, I don't really give a shit about this at all. I don't want to be in a Star War. But then I kept thinking, and I was like, wait, hold on, no, there is. There's an Asian in Star Wars. Super important guy, it's Yoda. He's got his Asian for sure. He's the last Asian. That explains the rest of it. There's no more. I've got evidence backed up, right? I mean, just look at him. He looks like a shriveled onion, right? He's just like right here. He's like 5 apples tall. It's about, English is kind of weird for him. Lives alone in a cave and just waiting for somebody he can teach space karate to. That's his life, right? And the final, all right, final piece of evidence, if I were to take a portrait of Yoda right here, and then my grandmother right there, and I told you, you pick Yoda, you would be like, ah. Dude. Dad, Yoda? And I'll be like, trick question, motherfucker, they're both my grandmother. You are a racist person. I will be lying about this immediately. All right, that's going to do it for me, folks. Thank you.